God said that if we don't praise him, he'll raise up stones. He'll raise up the very things that we don't want to praise him. If we don't praise him, he'll cause the things that are shameful to us to praise him. And so we have to praise. Hallelujah, this morning. You are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy. You are worthy this morning. You are worthy, Jesus. We give you praise this morning. You are King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Oh Lord, we put aside of our God situations this morning. We remember, oh God, our distress, but we choose to praise you this morning. We find deliverance in our praise this morning. We find comfort and safety. Your word said, oh God, your name is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and they are saved this morning. Lord, we abide this morning under your wings. We run under your wings this morning. We use your name as a covering this morning. As one voice, we lift you up. We lift you up with one voice this morning. Hallelujah, you are worthy. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, you are raised, you are high. Oh Lord, you reign, you reign. We praise you this morning, Jesus. Oh Emmanuel, oh King of Kings, Lord of Lords, conquering Lion of the Tribe of Judah, the great I am, the Lamb that was slain, old Lion and old Lamb, we praise you this morning. We praise you this morning. You are great, greatly to be praised. We are careful to praise you this morning. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This morning I'll share with you from the book of Psalms, Psalms 110, the entire chapter. Hallelujah this morning. Praise ye the Lord. The Lord said unto my Lord, sit thou at my right hand until I make thine enemies thy footstool. The Lord shall send the rod of thy strength out of Zion. Hallelujah. Rule thou in the midst of thine enemies. Thy people shall be willing in the day of thy power, in the beauties of holiness. From the womb of the morning, thou hast the dew of thy youth. The Lord hath sworn and will not repent. Thou art a priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. The Lord at thy right hand shall strike through kings in the day of his wrath. He shall judge among the heathens, and he shall fill places with the dead bodies. He shall wound the heads over many countries. He shall drink of the brook in the way, and therefore shall he lift up the head. We serve a ruling Jesus. We serve a mighty king. We serve a priest. His priesthood can never wear out. It can never come to an end. It can never retire. He's King of Kings and he's Lord of Lords this morning. Oh God, this morning we thank you for bringing us into this place. God, you are so good and you are so merciful. Oh God, we know that what we would have gone through the past week, oh God, we know the stresses of life, but we rely on you, oh God. We are relying on you. We know what this year would have brought, but we relied on you. Oh God, we recognize this year has taught us, oh God, that the wisdom of men is still foolish, that the foolishness of God is still wiser than any wisdom that man could offer us, oh God. And so we continue to rely, oh God, on your mercy this morning. We rely this morning on your grace. We thank you, oh God, for your loving kindness towards us, your people. You have brought us to this place this morning, and we are ever grateful. Lord, let everything that comes, oh God, from the bowels of this people, oh God, be beautiful in your sight. Reach down this morning, oh God, and touch the hearts, oh God, of the men that would stand before you. All of us in this congregation, oh God, we come before you, brokenhearted, oh God, and with contrite spirits, in recognition, oh God, that only you, oh God, can change and heal us this morning. We come to this place, oh God, as a body for healing, oh God, and for the opening of the mind and for a refreshing of the spirit that only you, oh God, could give. You admonished the disciples. You said you have to go. It's good that you go because you'd send your Holy Spirit. Let that spirit now, oh God, so reign in our hearts this morning. Quicken these mortal bodies this morning. Even right now in this place, oh God, let your mercy fall on these mortal bodies. Yea, Holy Spirit, fall now. Oh God, walk a miracle this morning. Walk miracles in the lives of this people, oh God, this your people. This morning, God, these are yours. Your word said that none that you would have given unto Christ would fall, would go away from his hand. He will be able to keep us against that day. Hallelujah, this morning. And so we repeat your word to you because we know that you are able. Everything that your word have said, everything that you have said would never return unto you void. You would keep this people, oh God, this morning. You are the keeper of the people. You are the author and the finisher of the faith this morning. We can rest in you. Let us find rest in your name. Let us find rest in your presence. Let your presence rain down on these people this morning. On we, your people, oh God, let your presence rain down. Let our hearts be stirred up this morning. Stir up, oh God, our hearts. Stir up the hearts of the people this morning. Stir it up, oh God, this morning. Let the hearts of the people be stirred up by your Holy Spirit. Stir up compassion in our hearts. Stir up mercy in our hearts, God. Stir it up, oh God. Lord, you said this kingdom, oh God, has often been threatened with violence. Let there be a violent stirring up of the heart of the people. A stirring up, oh God, that will create change in this community. A stirring up that would create change in our homes. Change, oh God, in our lives. A burst of light, oh God, from this people. Your word have said it, oh God. It's the light, oh God, that would cut through the darkness. So we believe it this morning. Touch the ones who would play the instruments, Father. The ones who would sing. The ones who would bring the word. Let your Holy Spirit come through clean and clear. Give us an ear for understanding, oh God. Hearts that are receptive. Minds, oh God, that are ready to be changed by you this morning. Thank you for what you're going to do. We exalt you, O God, because you are worthy. There is none like you, Jesus. How great you are. Bless your holy name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Worship team. Hallelujah.
Worship the Lord this morning, for indeed God is good. He's a good God, and we declare that he is indeed great and greatly to be praised. So let's worship the Lord this morning in the presence of his holiness. Hallelujah, because we serve a big and mighty God. So let's dance in his presence. Let's rejoice in his presence, because he is indeed worthy. My God is worthy to be praised. He is worthy to be praised this morning. Hallelujah. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you, God. Hallelujah. Clap your hands in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah.
Lord, you are good and your mercies endure forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endure forever. Lord, you are good and your mercy endure forever.
Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endure forever.
People from every nation and tongue, from generation to generation, we worship you.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, we worship you for who you are.
We worship,
we worship.
Hallelujah.
You.
your mercy endureth forever.
Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth.
Hallelujah, he's a good God this morning.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever.
Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever.
I feel like singing that one more time. Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good and your mercy
endureth forever. Hallelujah. We worship you, Lord. Lord.
Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever.
People
from every nation and town, from generation to generation, we worship you.
Continuously give him praise, for he is good. He is worthy to be praised this morning, saints.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So sing praises unto God this morning.
Hallelujah.
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 Regardless of the situation, give him praise. When troubles in your life, give him praise. When disappointment come your way, give him praise. Hallelujah. For he is worthy to be praised this morning.
Sing praises unto God, sing praises. Sing praises unto God, sing praises.
Hallelujah.
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 Oh God, for
We praise you regardless of the circumstances this morning. Hallelujah. We honor you, Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 And God, he has been so good to us.
Yes.
Regardless of the circumstances this morning.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
What a God we serve.
Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
We may be disappointed. Hallelujah. But regardless of the disappointments this morning,
hallelujah,
we have to give him praise.
Yes.
We have to give him honor. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We worship you, Jesus.
We worship,
we worship you, Lord.
We worship you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
We worship you, God. Let's worship the Lord this morning.
Hallelujah.
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 Thank you. In all circumstances, we give him praise. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship your name. We worship, we worship, we worship your name.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Jesus, you are so good to me. Circumstances, in no circumstances, oh, Jesus, you are so good to me, in no circumstances, in no circumstances, Jesus, you are,
Jesus, you are so good to me.
Intentional.
circumstances, in all circumstances.
Oh, Jesus, you are so good to me. In all circumstances.
This morning, tithes and offering.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
In all circumstances, God has been good to us. Give him praise again, saints, because he's worthy. He's worthy to be praised. We've now come to the point in our worship where we worship through our giving. Hallelujah. God, I give you thanks and I give you praise for this opportunity to give, oh God, of our finances. I thank you, oh God, for the jobs that you would have provided for your people. Thank you, oh God, for opening, oh God, your blessings from heaven, your windows of heaven, and pouring out blessings, oh God, into our homes.
Yes.
Oh God, we thank you for being our provider.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for the health and strength, oh God, that you have given to us, your people, to walk. Open our understandings, oh God, so that we may give freely, oh God, understanding that you would have given unto us, and so it's only right that we return unto you, that we bless others, oh God, that we help others, that our bowels of mercies will be open towards other people this morning. Give us a right understanding, oh God, about giving. Show us, oh God, the joy that comes from giving, oh God. Bless, oh God, the hands of those who have the strength to walk and to give back. And bless, oh God, those who may not have the strength of hands and body and who might not have jobs, oh God. Show them, oh God, and give them the wisdom, oh God. I thank you for what you're going to do in our lives. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah. Indeed, this morning we serve a good God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. my buckler, shield high tower. There's none greater than when the enemy comes against me. The Lord Sabaoth, he opposed me. He's my buckler, shield high tower. There's none greater than God is. God is a good God. He is
a great God.
Every rank of evil of the enemy, we must stand strong, hold on to your ground. For the battle is for we wrestle, principalities. Every rank of evil of the enemy, we must stand strong, hold on to your ground. For the battle, for we wrestle, principalities. Every rank of evil of the enemy, we must stand strong, hold on to your ground. For the battle is already won. God is a good God.
He is a great God.
Sing God is. Trample and dismantle every wicked scheme of the enemy. Put your armor on, stand up and be strong, for the battle is already won. God is a good God.
He is a great God.
Sing God
is.
Let's continue to give God praise this morning.
Hallelujah.
He is our King. Hallelujah.
We
saw our King this morning.
Oh,
hallelujah.
We
are royalties. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
It's a good God. Thank
we
you,
bless
Jesus.
Your name. We bless
hallelujah.
Your name. Hallelujah.
Let the King of my heart be the mountain where I run.
Yes.
The fountain I drink from. Oh, he is my song. Let the King of my heart be the shadow where I hide. The ransom of my life. Oh, he is my. Let the King.
Let the King of my heart be the fountain where I run.
Hallelujah.
The fountain I drink from, oh, he is my song. Let the King of my heart be the shadow where I hide. My song, 'cause you are good. You're good. Good. You are good.
Hallelujah.
You're good. Good.
You are good.
You are good. You're good. Good. You are good. You're good. King of my heart, be the man inside my sails, the anchor of the waves. Oh, he is my song. Let the king of my heart
be the fire inside my veins,
the anchor of my days. Oh, he is my song. Let the king of my heart be the wind inside my sails, the anchor in my waves. Oh, he is my song. Let the king of my heart be the fire inside my veins, the anchor of my days. Oh, he is my.
Hallelujah!
You're good.
You are good, God this morning.
Oh,
we
love you, Lord. For your mercy never fails me in all my days. I've been held in your hand
from the moment
that I wake up
until I lay my head.
Until I lay my head,
I will sing of his goodness.
I will sing,
hallelujah,
of the goodness of God.
We have to continue to give him praise. Hallelujah. He's such a good God. He's such a faithful God. Hallelujah. Don't ever give up on Jesus this morning. Don't ever give up. Hold on. Hold on, saints. Hallelujah. His goodness. Hallelujah.
It's running after me. Your goodness is running after, it's running after me.
Hallelujah! Thank you for your goodness this morning.
Hallelujah!
Let's give God a clap offering this morning.
Hallelujah.
He's worthy to be praised.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah! We worship you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We give God praise for his goodness. Hallelujah. This morning, the Cara juniors of the Cara Dance Ministry will now minister to us in the form of a dance. Can I ask for some assistance with clearing the stage area?
Anaga.
Intimidates and some very special guests. So let's put our hands together this morning for the Cara Juniors, Intimidates and special guests. Let's make them feel welcome.
Onaga. Hey!
Yeah.
welcome. Working. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together once more for Cara Juniors, Intermediates, and our very special guests, the mommies. Give them a round of applause. God is indeed working.
Thank you, Cara, and we pray that the Lord will continue to bless and stir up the hearts of those who are charged with leading them and teaching them this morning. We now join me in welcoming our dear and senior pastor, Bishop Gilbert Porter.
Good to be in the house of the Lord. And I heard all the rains last night. I thought today was going to be one of those kind of days. God is good. You stand with me. Turn your Bibles to Galatians chapter 4, verse 4 and 5. Galatians 4, verse 4 and 5. But when the fullness of time was come, God sent forth his son, made of a woman, made under the law, to redeem them that were under the curse of the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons. Now you read for me, same portion. Father, thank you for your word. Thank you, Lord, that we still have the freedom to come publicly, fellowshipping together, and feasting on your word. Touch our hearts, O Lord. I come against every distraction right now. Every spirit of distraction that will seek to snatch your word. Oh, that your word would fall on good ground and that it would bring forth fruit. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let your presence dwell in this place like never before. Let those who come seeking you find you. Oh Lord God, be with us, Lord. Be with us, oh Lord. For if you don't come to our rescue, we'll be lost. We need you, Lord. I need you. Let your presence fall afresh. Your manifest presence, oh God. Oh, make that sad heart joyful. Make that burdened heart light. Make that confused mind be at peace, oh Lord. For you are the Prince of Peace. Most of all, you be glorified, oh God. You be glorified. In Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. You may have your seats. Bless the Lord. I know the welcome will come a little bit later. But I can't help but say it's nice to see you, Niall. It's great to see you. I want to speak to us on the subject, the significance of Christmas. The significance of Christmas. Christ was born at a time when ignorance, superstition, greed, hatred, and hypocrisy prevailed among God's people. Purity and morality was long forgotten. Sitting on the throne of Israel was a king who was not from the Davidic lineage. Herod was from the lineage of Esau. And the person that occupied the high priest's office was not from the lineage of Aaron. He was placed there by the Roman government. All the offices among the people of God was for political expediency, but were not in line with the precepts of God. When Herod heard the news that a king was born, one can imagine why he was so scared. After all, he was an imposter. He was not supposed to be on the throne. For God had said to David, "There will always be a man from your loins sitting on the throne." We are very familiar with the story, what theologians dub as the incarnation or incarnation, when God became man, when God chose to leave the splendor of heaven and occupy his footstool, earth. Herod went about trying to kill every possibility. Herod went about trying to kill every chance that a true leader would rise. Now, I couldn't preach a sermon like this before election. But now that election's over. Amen? Herod went about killing every boy who is beyond or below the age of 12. It is not unlike today that the enemy has targeted our boys. I have learned that Satan don't have any new tricks. He just does the same thing over and over again. What he doesn't do is give up. He will beat and beat and beat, and hopefully something will crack. Herod wanted to kill the future of Israel. Just like the enemy wants to kill the future of our country. Now, for those of you who are a little inclined to feminism, I apologize. I am not in any way trying to suggest that the female gender is not the future. Because I believe that all our children are the future. But we cannot ignore that the enemy has targeted our boys. Look, explain to me why in St. Vincent and the Grenadines, at enrollment at kindergarten, there are more boys than girls. But by the time you get to grade 6, something seemed to have happened. That more girls write the CPEA exam than boys. What happened to the boys along the way? Explain to me that at secondary school, that girls far surpass the number of boys who graduate Form 5. I remember attending a certain school's graduation, the graduation ceremony. It was a co-ed school, so boys and girls went there. And I couldn't help but notice that when the girls' names were called to go up for their certificates, they walked briskly and they went up with energy and they were seemingly happy to collect their certificates. But the boys were like this. Like they're on a runway. No energy. Just lackluster. Our boys prefer to sit down for the whole day on their gadgets playing games. And we parents ensure that the girls spend some time in their books and come out something, because we don't want any man to ill-treat them. But the problem persists even further, that it's even worse at university. I remember being in a tutorial class of 25 people, 3 men, 22 women. And the tutor did something that was not so good. He said to us guys, because he was putting us in groups, he said, and there were 5 groups, he said, choose which group you want to go into. Now, you know, if you choose one over the other, what happens? And every group wanted a male inside of their group. But there were only 3 of us. There is a problem. The enemy has targeted our males. We haven't even reached the church. The men generally would stay back, and the women would be up front. You need something done? Get a woman. It is a trick of the enemy, because in the family, us men keep our hands off the rearing of our children. We see our jobs only to provide and now and again to discipline. But it's the mother who has to sit with the children and go through their schoolwork with them and teach them things. There is a problem. Pastor, what all this has to do with Christmas? I find it, however, amazing, and I'm getting somewhere, that God chose such a terrible time and called it the fullness of time. A time where men push each other down to get ahead. A time where men lorded things over God. A time where men wanted to show that they were better than others. God called it the fullness of time. You read it in Galatians. For when the fullness of time was come, God did what? He sent forth his son. My brothers and sisters, I want to tell you that all is not lost. That even though things seem to be going out of hand, even though there seem to be no hope, even though it seems to be getting worse and worse, and worse, God is still in charge. God is still able to do mighty things in our lives and in our nation. God didn't focus on the fact that the one who was there to represent him, the priest, was not fit for the office. God was not so much concerned that Herod the king was an imposter. God said, this is the right time. You might even want to take this particular principle and apply it to your personal life. Because when it seems like if everything is going wrong, it's a time for a miracle from God. It's a time for an intervention from God. It's a time when we will see the wonder working power of God. If everything is going right, you don't need no miracle. If you're not sick, you don't need a healer. If you're not in need, you don't need a provider. If you don't have trouble, you don't need someone to come and say, peace, be still. Don't be so wrapped up in the storms of life, but look at the one who can speak to the storm. The message, the Christmas message, is that all is not lost. That God can do many, many, many things that we can't even begin to imagine. The word says he's a mysterious God. His wonders to perform. It may not happen the way you expect. expect it to happen. It may not be going the way you hope it will go, but God is still sitting on his throne and he is still in charge. I heard the worship team singing it. He said, it doesn't matter, God is still God. So in the midst of these conditions, Christ was born. And he began a season of transformation. He was strange to the people because he taught them the word of God. It was not a word that was popular among those who are more concerned with making sure that they keep their place of power. It was not a word that was popular for the hearers because the word demanded action. It was not a feel-good word. It was not a word of bless me, bless me, bless me, bless me. Yeah, God, as he declared, and I'm when I say God, you know Jesus is God, right? He says, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because he has anointed me to preach the gospel to the poor. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted, to preach deliverance to the captives and recovery of sight to the blind, to set at liberty them that are bruised, to preach the acceptable year of the Lord. It was a word of hope, but it demanded change, and change is always a problem. Change comes with casualties. Many of us, most of us, would like change. None of us want to remain the same all the time. Some changes are not so good. Like I notice that my tie no longer falls down straight. It kind of loop over a little bit. Don't like that change. But change is a part of life. That anything that survives must change. Ask the caterpillar. If he remain a caterpillar, he will shrivel up and die, but he must change and become something not so nice looking. But before you knew it, that ugly black thing that the caterpillar has changed to suddenly breaks open, and out of it comes a beautiful creature that most of us cannot help but stare at when we see them. Butterflies. Yeah, all the chemicals in the banana almost kill all of them. But I'm seeing some of them around now. Yes? Ask the parent who have given birth to a child, and after 1, 2, 3 years, the child is still lying down, can't creep, can't walk, can't talk, and still want breast milk. Well, some people had breast milk till they're about 5. I was told. Some used to go home break time when they live close to school. But a parent would get concerned that this baby is not changing. Some of the changes become a little bit of issue, for when they start moving around, they also start pulling down every single thing they could find. But all of that is part of growth. path of growth. Hear what the word of the Lord says about us. 2 Corinthians 5 and verse 17, it says, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. And behold, all things become new. Change. Change. The time was right. God sent his son. Why did he come? Why did he come? Based on our experiences and our knowledge, we would have many answers to that question. Some would say, if you only know who I was, and you now see who I am, you would know why Christ came. And that's the truth. But I want to share with you just some points, and I'm going to try and go quickly. If you're writing, write quick. One, he came to fulfill prophecy. He came to fulfill prophecy. Romans 15 and verse 8 says, Christ has become a servant to confirm the promises given to the fathers. It was prophesied long ago that one will come. Isaiah got some of the prophecies. Isaiah said, he shall be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. Another one said, his name shall be Emmanuel. God will come and dwell with us. Prophecy after prophecy. Number two, he came to fulfill the law. He came to fulfill the law. I am confident that I couldn't survive under the law. Someone asked me on Friday night, when all the food sharing and the little ham on the side, Pastor, you eat pork? I said to the individual, I just eat ham too. Because somebody tell me that pork and ham are different. Ask my wife. I traveled from the USA, New York. A friend of mine gave me a whole leg of pork, baked. The butcher took out the bones and sewed it back up. And she baked it the way I like it. And she, I saw her the day before I was leaving, and she said, Porter, I have something for you. One whole leg of pork. If you see me going through JFK with my leg of pork, and they flag me down, I heard back check. I stood, asked me what is inside the bag, I said it's my pork. They said we have to test it, I said no problem. Came out with his Q-tip, gloves, dab the thing on top, the shine paper, foil paper. Went somewhere, came back, he said, we have to send it through again. I said, don't worry, sir. I am not going anywhere, leave my pork. I thought I would have had problems in Barbados, but I had none. Barbadian love pork. I think there's some statistics that Bajan eat the most chicken per capita in the world. But one thing I know about them, they love pork. I had no problem there. The point is, I couldn't live under the law. I wouldn't say no more there. Jesus came. Matthew 5:17, if you're writing. Matthew 5:17-18. Jesus said, "Do not think that I came to abolish the law or the prophets. I did not come to abolish, but to fulfill it. Not the smallest letter or stroke shall pass from the law until it is accomplished." In case you're a little bit confused, because of Christ, I can bless and eat. To call nothing that God made unclean, but give God thanks. Amen. Number three, he came to seek and to save the lost. Luke 19:10. He came to seek and to save the lost. Matthew 18:11. And here's one that we have a little problem with. He came to serve. He came to be a servant. It is said the true test of a man is to give him power. If you want to see what an individual is made up of, give them power. God have a habit of turning things upside down. So hear what the word of God says. Those of us who lead must be the servant. I get 2.5, amen. Those of us who have been placed in positions where we are called to lead the people of God in whatever capacity must know that we have been called to serve the people of God. Pastor, may I serve God? Amen. But here the thing, you can't serve God and not serve his people. Just like you can't love God and not love his people. Yes? He came to serve so that when Peter refused for Jesus to wipe and wash his feet, Jesus said, "If you don't allow me, you will not be a part of me, because I want you to mirror what I am doing. You call me Lord, but here I am fulfilling the role of a slave." You're called to serve God's people. Number six, he came to give his life as a ransom. That should make us happy. Because if he did not come to die, we would not have lived. If Jesus didn't come to die, we would have all still been dead in sins and trespasses. He said, "I will take your curse and give you blessings. I will take your burdens and give you my light one." He said, "I will take your sickness and give you my healing. I will take your mess and give you crumbs of righteousness. I will take everything that is wrong that you have, and I'll make you joint heirs with me. You are mine. You are no longer strangers. You are now adopted. And I heard something recently that just tickled my mind. I can't remember who said it, but it made a lot of sense to me. The person said, sometimes parents will not intentionally go and try to have a child, but the child comes. Yes? So we were not really trying. In fact, in some cases, they were trying not to have. But something happened. But the person said, they have never heard any time in their life that someone did not intentionally try to adopt a child. But it happened. That everyone who adopts makes a very intentional decision that I am choosing this child and I'm going to give this child my name and this child is going to become mine legally. I say, wow. Because the word of God says to me that I am adopted. That God intentionally chose me. 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 That God who knows me inside out still chose me. That God who knows that I have issues and still chose me. When Samantha chose me, she didn't know all of my bad ways, right? Thank God she didn't know all. But I believe she'll still choose me. Eh? He saw you before the foundations of the earth. He knew you. And he chose you and said, you are mine. I'm going to give you my name and you can call me Abba, Father. Abba, Father. You have been chosen to be joint heirs with my only begotten Son. I don't know if you fully grasp what has happened. And maybe we would never really know until. But for the little that I know, it blew my mind. It made me walk with a little more spunk in my steps. So that even when people say that I am not much, me say, you and God don't agree. Because God, he called me his own. I am prince. I am royalty. I am a member of the royal priesthood. I am a member of the holy nation. I am special before the Lord. He combs the very hair on my head. I belong to God. I am special. And you are if you belong to him. I was saying to the new believers this morning, look, you do not believe the lies of the devil. One of the devil's chief weapon is called deception. He tells lies. The word says he's the father of lies. So hear what he does. Do you remember Eve? Did God say that you should not eat of this fruit or partake of it? Eve say yes. He said that I would die. God not telling you the truth. He doesn't want you to become like him. Because the day you eat, you will become like him. And the word say Eve looked at the fruit. And she saw that it was nice looking and attractive. And so she took and ate. Why are we so quick to believe the lies of the enemy? What have God said about you? But why is it so easy to hold on to what the enemy say? Because anything that is said that is not in alignment with what God say is a lie. So I would do like what Isaiah said. I would believe the report of the Lord. You might say that I'm not going anywhere. But what did God say? God said, his plans for me, they are plans of peace and not of evil. And that he would bring me to an expected end. You might say that I have nothing. But God said that I should not worry. Because if he takes care of the birds and the lilies, how much more to his son? Number 7. He came that we might have life more abundantly. He came that we might have life more abundantly. God does not intend for us to just get through life. God does not intend for us to just barely make it. As the old people say, by the skin of the teeth. God's plans for you are plans of abundance. Now, unfortunately, when we hear abundance, the only thing we think about is money. And yes, it may include money, but it cannot only be money. Ask the person who have so much money that they can't even spend it in their lifetime, but they are miserable. Yes, I know money would move some of the misery, but it can't move all. Let me explain something to you. One of the greatest problems that the rich have is that they don't know who really care about them. They're not sure who really want to be their friend, because they want to be their friend, not because of what they can get. Rich people don't know who to trust. But when you're poor and people still want to be your friend, you know them are right there. Oh, they can't. They're not. That's a real friend. No, I mean, I'm not in any way trying to laud poverty. I hate poverty. I think poverty is a curse. Yes. But not everybody going to get rich. Don't believe the lie. Not everybody is going to get rich. And you don't have to be rich to be happy. What the word encourages is sufficiency. Yes? And having enough to help others. Having enough to help others. The rich man is always concerned about the fact that he might get poor one of these days. They live in torment. And the word says, don't set your heart on riches, for they can vanish. For those of you who study economics, you know that when there's inflation, that the value of the money you have immediately reduced. Let me give you a vivid example. When I was a little boy, $1 used to get me 10 bread. Yeah? What we call the penny bread. $1 and I get 10. How much that $1 will get me now? None. I have to put another one and get how much? 5. No, I never see the 4. Oh, they have 4 too? Lord have mercy. So effectively, the value of a dollar is no longer that amount. It's not as valuable anymore. The vagrants on the street, they no longer ask you for 10 cents and 25 cents. Because they understand you cannot set your heart on money. But you ask God to meet your needs. To meet your needs. And to give you enough that you can be a blessing to others. Amen? All right, I'll do 2 more. I do have a lot more here, but I'll do 2 more. Yes. Jesus came to reveal the Father. Jesus came to reveal the Father. Matthew 11 and verse 27 says, nor does anyone know the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wills to reveal him. John 14:9 says, Jesus said to him, he who has seen me have seen the Father. Who do you reveal? When people see us, who do they see? Don't answer. Just think about it. Yes? When people see us on the bus, who do they see? When people see us on the job, who do they see? If you want, you can come talk to me after. The final one I will do is that he came to do the will of the Father. It was not about him. We're still talking Christmas here. It was not about him. Everything he did, it was about the Father. What are we instructed to do? That we are to do likewise. That we are to say, not my will, but yours. Jesus said, you must crucify yourself. Crucify your will. Crucify your wants. And follow him. I know it's not the kind of gospel that goes around these days. I know the gospel that goes around these days say, bring $1,000 and God will give you $10,000. And whether you're married or not, I prophesy a husband for you. And wherever the sole of your foot tread, claim it. It's yours. Even though it belongs to other people. I know that this is not the kind of gospel. And I'm sorry. But I have to tell you the truth. Christmas is about a transformed life. It's about a transformed life. And when our lives are transformed, it will positively draw others to Christ. There's no greater testimony than when your neighbors observe your changes. There's no greater testimony than when those who knew you and now seeing you, say, something happened. There's a story about a great evangelist. He was not saved at the time. And his wife got saved. And he was mad. One day she left and went to church a night in the winter. And he locked her out of the house. She came, she knocked, and he did not open. We're talking about winter. Eh? She slept on the porch. Next morning, he woke up and he opened the door and she got up. And she said, good morning, honey. What would you like for breakfast? And she went into the kitchen and she didn't poison him. She made him breakfast. And he was amazed because he couldn't figure out, how is it that you can treat me so good when I have treated you so poorly? The next Sunday, he was in church because he wanted to see what made the difference. Got saved. And he became one of the greatest evangelists that this century has seen. Causing millions to hear the gospel and to come to Christ. He got saved because of the testimony of his wife. Without her speaking a word, he saw Christ in her. I encourage you, take this season to do some introspection. Take this season to spread the message of the gospel with our lives. With our lives. The neighbor that you're not talking to anymore, go and repent. And start show them the love of God. Yes, they did you wrong. Yes, they were wrong. But show them the love of God. The church member that you. Amen. Yes. The brother, the sister who did you badly. Show them the love of Christ. They will be better for it. You will be better for it. And God will be glorified. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Let's stand. I feel like singing, "You're my brother, you're my sister." I don't know where I want to come from. Who's going to help me? Worship team? You're my brother, you're my sister. And they say in COVID, they can't shake hands. People like they don't study COVID anymore. Well, I'm not going to instruct you to shake or don't shake. It's your choice. But
you're my brother, you're my sister, so take me by the hand. Together we will walk until he comes. There's no foe that can defeat us. We're walking side by side. As long as there is love, we will stand. You're my brother, you're my sister, so take me by the hand. Together we will walk until he comes. There's no foe that can defeat us when we are walking side by side. As long as there is love, we will stand. You're my brother, you're my sister, so take me by the hand. Wonderful people, I love that thrill that I feel when I get together with people. I love that thrill that I feel when I get together with God's wonderful people. I love to see those happy faces praising God in the heavenly places. Thrill that I feel when I get together with God. Wonderful people, love that thrill that I feel when I get together with God's wonderful people. I love to see those happy faces praising God in the heavenly places. The thrill that I feel when I get together with God, God, wonderful people. You're my brother, you're my sister, so take me by the hand. Together we will walk until he As long as there is love, we will stand. As long as there is love, we will stand.
Bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Every now and again, I begin to wonder what would heaven be like. I know a lot of singing will go on up there. And a lot of worship. The Bible does talk about a supper. Sounds like food to me. Talks about the tree of life. And a fountain of living water. Jesus mentioned something about mansions. He said, I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there ye will be also. When you think about heaven, how do you feel? If you are afraid, if you are unsure, now is the time to change that. Is there anyone here who hear the call of God pulling you to come to Him? Will you give Him your heart this afternoon? Would you give Him your heart this afternoon? If you are in this audience, I'm not sure if we're still streaming. But if you are here and the Spirit of God is, and you don't know it's the Spirit, you just feel a particular way and you, it's like if someone is just getting your attention to think of your life. That's actually the Holy Spirit. He's calling you. He's calling you to a better place. Would you come? I would like to pray for you. Would you accept His call and surrender your life to Him? I would like to pray for you. Or if you have been walking this road, but you know that really you're in a backslidden condition, you really want to do what is right, but you find yourself doing what is wrong. Would you just cry out to Jesus and ask Him for help? The Bible says that Peter, when he took his eyes off Jesus, he began to sink. But as he was sinking, he said, Lord, help me. And Jesus took him by the hand and saved him. It's time for you to cry to Jesus and ask Him for help. Father, I pray for those who fit those descriptions. Continue to speak to their heart, O Lord. Trouble them. Trouble them, Lord. Give them no rest until they surrender their all to You. Don't allow them of peace until they say, all to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. I commit them into your hands now, Lord. Give them, Lord, that boldness, that faith, that courage to say, I don't know how it's going to work out, but I'm gonna give my heart to the Lord. I don't know if I would make it, but I'm gonna give my heart to the Lord. I'm just gonna surrender my life to him. Thank you, Father. I pray for those who are not well in their bodies, those who are sick, battling with different forms of sicknesses. Jesus, by your stripes, please heal them. Remove every trace of their ailments. And use, oh God, this miracle as a testimony that you are still Jehovah Rapha, the God who heals. I pray for those whose homes are broken. Lord God, you are the Prince of Peace. I speak for peace in their homes right now in the name of Jesus. Mend broken relationships, oh God. Mend, oh God, sibling relationships. Mend, oh Lord, parental relationships. Mend marital relationships. Mend relatives, oh God, in the name of Jesus. And let peace prevail. I pray for those who are in need, O Lord. Move upon the hearts of those within their sphere to assist where they can. Provide, I pray, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Father, in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. Praise God.
Good morning, afternoon, once more. It was a pleasure having you worship with us. I want to take this opportunity to welcome all of our friends, our well-wishers, and our members into the house of the Lord this morning, and to celebrate with those who have birthdays or anniversaries. If there are any such persons among us,